Hello everybody. So if you watched my last video, we created an API using Flask and we deployed it to Google Cloud Platform. This time, however, we're going to use FastAPI. FastAPI with a machine learning model for sentiment analysis. So let's get going. So what is FastAPI? FastAPI is a modern, fast, high-performance web framework for building APIs with Python 3.6 plus based on standard Python type hints. So it's fast, fast to code, fewer bugs, intuitive. One of the big bonuses is that it's got very good error checking. You don't need to put loads of bespoke custom error checks in by yourself. And it's standards-based, robust, and short. So if you remember what I did in the last video, I'll put the link here somewhere. And what we did instead for this project was, let me show you. So the main function was very similar. I just had to modify it slightly, but the imports, the first thing you'll notice is instead of import Flask, import Flask RESTful, we've used from FastAPI, import FastAPI. I've also used Pydantic. I've used that down here to actually allow me to use the base model. And the base model is a class which is then passed to the instance of that is then passed down here to the predict method, which then does the sentiment analysis and returns a positive or a negative in a dictionary. So I'm not going to actually type all this code out because it's quite brief and really I've kind of done it in the previous video. So here, I'm just want to sort of highlight the differences. So FastAPI, as we've just seen, is a new framework. Base model, you need that here for the class so that you can gather, create a new string object from the given object. The given object being the sentence that we want to pass in for sentiment analysis. So unlike when you're using Flask, obviously app equals Flask and then in brackets under name, here we just say app equals FastAPI. So we create the instance and then we use the at, so the wrapper app.post. We're going to use post here rather than request just for change. Test data, so the test data is equal to data.input sentence, which comes from here. So this method uses data and the data comes from the request body. This is the same as before. So NLTK download, we're using Veda, which is very good for analyzing social media posts, etc. It gives it a score. If the score is greater than 0, then the sentiment is positive. Else it's negative, and then we return the output. So that's in summary, that is the code. So let's just talk about how we test it now. So rather than using Flask, we test it with, let me show you, uvicorn, uvicorn, then main colon app. So main, obviously, or main here matches the name of the file up here, and hyphen hyphen reload so that it automatically refreshes when you're testing it. Right, so if you're ready to see it being tested, I'm going to run it. And similarly to Flask, you'll see, we'll watch for changes in these directories. Uvicorn running on HTTP 127.0.0.1 port 8000. So if we go to the link, and that's nothing to worry about because we haven't put in the predict. See on line 15, we've got predict. So predict. And then it says method not allowed. So then, We need to pass it actually a request. So what we'll do to test it. Move that out of the way is we will do this. So import requests, URL equals 1000, which is matches that. Yep. User data, so we just pass it a JSON dictionary, the input sentence. The input sentence here needs to be called the same as this, because this is what the predict method is expecting. So if we answer equals request.post JSON, because we're using post, we'll do JSON equals user data, and then we'll print the answer. So if we run this, and just bear with, just have to clear the output there. Okay, so run, and there we go. Obviously, VS Code Code Runner just does Python dash user, then fills in the path for us. Sentiment equals positive. So, wow, not very amazing. Let's just change that and see if it gives us negative sentiment. Oh dear. I think the wow has kept it on positive. Try again. There we go, now it's negative. So not very, that obviously it knows it's not impressive, so it's not. I wonder what it'll say if it says not bad. Yeah, positive. Not, let's say not brilliant, but okay. That should be fairly neutral. I'm interested as to what this is going to say. Yeah, I think it's because it's got the not. Let's see if it just says what it says if it's okay. That's probably negative. No, it's positive. Okay. It's, I wonder what if we say it's adequate. Yeah, positive, it's adequate, it's okay. It's slightly less than adequate, so this should be negative. It's still saying it's positive, so yeah, I don't entirely agree with this. It's slightly less than adequate. Let's try acceptable. It's slightly less than acceptable. Anyway, hopefully you're seeing the benefits of using FastAPI, the code. Yeah, there we go, negative now. So it's not that great. Whereas this tutorial obviously is. Right, okay, so this is just kind of a short follow-up to the previous video, and much of what I did in the last video still stands, but this is just how to use FastAPI rather than Flask, Flask RESTful. And as you can see, the code is actually a lot shorter. So yeah, good. Next, onwards and upwards. I think in the next video, we'll look at consuming the API and probably look at how to use additional endpoints and work with additional functions. So yeah, thanks for watching. I'll be back soon.